Neil Ganguly is the managing director of the automotive practice at Deloitte. And Neil, you guys have just come out with a supplier survey or a study of what's going on there. What are the key findings?
That's correct. So, John, this is our 2019 Global Annual Supplier Study. Although we call it annual, it happens once every 2 years, and this is our fourth one. So we've been doing this the last 8 years, and I'll tell you right now that what we've seen for this year's study is there's the divergence between performance across supply base is increasing. We have about, let me illustrate that, we have about 200 plus suppliers in our database, and coming out of the downturn, that body of suppliers has created about $500 billion in shareholder value. However, the top third account for 99% of that number. So the rest of the 67% are either kind of going lateral or losing value.
Why is that? What are the key findings for the companies that are not moving forward?
Right, and so we dove down into sort of segments, the products that these suppliers are making and selling every day, right? And we looked at, across 19 segments in the vehicle, you know, what is happening in these segments, right? And we found that the about $1.5 trillion industry that this is, right, there's clearly some growth areas which could grow up to 100, 200% over the next 10 years. There's some stagnant areas that are probably, in our opinion, going to be 0 to 5. And there's going to be areas that are going to lose up to 20% of value and erode revenue over the next 10 years.
What right? is that? So, is that in the internal combustion engine area?
Internal combustion engine area, commoditized, you know, hard parts and so on, right? And, you know, and we certainly have that study that you know, that shows that if you think about suppliers today and how they manage their business, when we did this the first time, the winning themes could be cost management, efficiency, performance, international growth, all those are great factors, but we believe that since there's such divergence now in the marketplace, and it's gonna increase, that differentiated strategies are required. And by that I mean, you gotta look at your product portfolio, and you gotta figure out, where am I playing, and how do I win here? Because the win theme in growth segments, M&A, partnership, investment, capital, is not going to be the same as your stagnant and declining segments. Consolidation, scale of economies, cost leadership, and so on. And this and all of it, there's a lot of external capital that's coming and will continue to come to the industry to reshape the value chain.
What's to say about the ones who are really struggling right now? The last decade has been phenomenal for the global
Absolutely.
Automotive industry. So if they're struggling in times of great growth, doesn't look good for the future.
Well, we look at it from a product portfolio perspective. You might be struggling in profitability in a certain portfolio because it's getting commoditized, because there's price pressure, lack of differentiation, right? But at the same time, as long as a car is made, that product's got to go in there. And so it'll be around. Now, do you want to go consolidate the industry? Or do you want to look at your portfolio and say, I want to harvest or divest some of these businesses? But the point we're making is, divergent futures will require differentiated strategies. And with that, the suppliers have to manage these businesses very differently. There's money to be made in consolidating segments. There's money to be made in harvesting segments. Don't get me wrong, the ICE will be around for a long time to come. Somebody's going to consolidate there and make some money, whether it's going to be the suppliers or external capital.
So what you're saying is, even though there might be some segments involved with the internal combustion engine that may not grow in the future, if you, as a player in the field, consolidate and start to build a good portfolio, you can survive.
Absolutely, and because there'll be the need for it, right? Even with hybrids, even with electrification, there's going to be hybrids for a long time. There's going to be big ICs with cars, SUVs, powerful engines for a long time. And so, again, our motto really is, if you're operating in a growth segment, you're looking for alliances, partnerships, M&A, how do I play this, right? What's the growth capital? What's the growth hypothesis? New business models and services and so on. If you're playing at the other end of the spectrum, your strategy is going to have to look different to make money.
Yeah, okay, that's one key finding.
Absolutely.
Any other one
Absolutely.
To point out to?
Yeah, and the second thing is, I think we need the linear value chain we know for a long time in the industry is going to be restructured, right? Again, because the OEMs, the external guys, right, and suppliers are trying to figure out how to play, particularly in the electronics and software arena, in the services arena, and we think that there's going to be a lot of money to be made. Despite the risks we talked about, we think there's $400 to $500 billion of value to be captured by somebody in the value chain. right? Whether it's OEMs that are trying to do so, suppliers are trying to do so, outside capital, electronics and tech companies are trying to do so. The future is going to have to look different because the competitive field is very different now for a supplier. It's not linear anymore.
Very interesting. So my takeaway from what you're saying here is that it's a tough business out there, but if you play your cards right, there's a huge opportunity for growth.
Huge value to be made. We think there's $500 billion. We made $500 billion, suppliers did, right, over 10 years. At least that much more to be made.
Well, good. Neil Ganguly, thanks for giving us this quick snapshot of your latest supplier survey.
Thanks, John. Always a pleasure to talk to you.
Shiloh designs and manufactures innovative, multi-component, multi-material, lightweight solutions. Our disruptive technologies are transforming the mobility industry, meeting the needs of our customers today and planning for tomorrow.